health crowded, and we definitely need to share bullets, is that also if you are only four people in an aisle ambulance or a pew, if you can possibly split, we have a few people that don't have a seat yet. And we'd really like to include everybody, so now it's time to get cozy with people you do know and don't know. So here's a couple of seats all on the aisle. The other question, we just want to make sure, does everybody have a candle? If you don't have candles yet, we're going to have the ushers come around to you now, so if you have them at the end of service. You have candles? I didn't think it was possible. You can look really exciting. All right, so I guess we're going to do family groups of sharing candles. So know that you have the light within you. You're going to need to have the light pass your hand over the light. All right. Wow, you guys are setting records here. What's that? Yeah, if anybody has candles they want to share, why don't you hold up a candle you want to share now, and we'll get those passed around. So Sue and Sandra, if you guys can come in and you know, raise your hand if you need a candle, and lift up a candle if you're sharing a candle. Raise your hand if you need a candle, and we'll try to get some more candles places where they need to go. How's the balcony doing? You guys more or less have enough candle? I see thumbs up there. Raise your hand if you want a candle, and then these guys are sharing candles. There's sharing going on over here. You guys are so nice. Keep a couple for your aisle at least, right? Or your pew. Oh, all right. So, three candles for sale. Candle for sale. Okay. Going once, going twice. Does anybody need a candle? Hands really up if you need one. Or if your whole pew doesn't have. Oh, two more, my goodness. It's a miracle of the loaves and the candles. Yay! Welcome to Jackson Community Church. And Merry Christmas Eve. My name is Reverend Gail Doktor. I'm a minister here at this church. And you are surrounded by people that come here every single week and people who are here for the first time. So welcome to all of you, regardless of where you are on your journey. We are grateful and pleased that you have chosen to gather with us this evening as we remember and tell the great story of the coming of light and love into the world. We will be celebrating largely with candles, with carols, and with calm response readings. Lori, who is our pianist, will be playing underneath all of the call and response. And you guys have a heart in every single time that we light the Advent candle. So we're going to divide you into two halves. See that little line down the middle? You're probably bumping up against it. You guys have a window between you, so you don't. So everybody on this side, raise your hands. Oh, good. All right. You guys are east. And everybody on this side, raise your hand. You're west. All right. So you're going to see throughout the readings this evening, east goes first, then the reader goes, then west, and then the reader starts. You're going to go back and forth and back and forth. So now you know who you are. All right, I'm going to and trust that the ushers are good with what they're doing, and we're going to begin with Gia and Chris Boston providing some special music.
Joy, 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 joy
taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever. Amen. So we're going to start right in with a quick reflection on song that I actually need the help of short people. Young and young at heart is generally what I'm after here to help me. We got a Christmas present for the church, and so I need some small people to help me look at this and figure out what's going on. Yeah, you too, Pia, for sure. Need know a little bit of some of what's going on. Can you guys unwrap this and then help everybody look at what you see? What do you guys see? You see nativity people. What do you guys see? What do you guys see? I see maybe two grown-ups and what else? A baby, okay. Did anybody look at the nativity scenes in the front and notice anything missing? Baby Jesus isn't in any of the nativity scenes except this one that we just got. So I think it's time to fix that because today's the day. Baby Jesus shows up. So guess what I happen to have? A plate full of baby Jesus in. I bet you there's enough for everybody to put one somewhere. Can you guys just take one? If you are okay. Yeah, take one baby Jesus. Make sure everybody gets a chance to reach her baby Jesus. Alright, and now, guess where we have to go to put these baby Jesuses down? We're going to bring them all, so let's not abandon any baby Jesuses. Alright, so if you want to carry two, you carry that one as well. Alright, everybody have something? Okay, we're going to go to the front now. Bye, you guys. We'll see you in a few minutes. You'll be able to hear what we're doing, though. We're going to go this way, and we're going to put all the baby Jesuses in a scene. Doesn't matter if they all match. That's kind of the beauty of baby Jesus. Baby Jesus goes where he needs to go. Love shows up and it never matches anybody else, and it's just right where it's supposed to be, you know? So can you guys find places? Yeah, that's a good idea. Oh, there's people with two babies in their hands. Did you get a baby? You didn't get babies. Who has two babies? You want to share a baby? Oh, all right. Now we need to. And it doesn't have to match, you guys. Just find a home for the baby. I see an empty basket up there. Yep, that one looks good. Why don't you go ahead and do that? And if we get two babies in one stable, he'll find his mom and dad later. It's all good. All right, after you've found a place for your baby. All right, everybody, you guys can go back and find your mom and dad, or your parents, or your guardians, or whoever you showed up with. Now, I think you've got all the kids mapped to the right pew, but I'm not 100% sure of that. We hope. So please don't go home with somebody else's baby Jesus or child. All Advent season, we've been talking about songs, the sacred songs that show up in the scriptures. And tonight, I want to simply remind you that those songs are a way of singing out, shouting out, and using your voice for healing, to call for social justice, call for change, to open yourself to transformation. Last year was the 200th anniversary of Silent Night, and this year is the 300th anniversary of Joy to the World. Both of these songs were written to encourage a different way of engaging the divine, of opening God or opening yourself to love in the whatever way you understand it. The young man that wrote Silent Night was illegitimate. He lived on the outskirts of a small village, and it was only because somebody recognized his musical talent that he was sent to school and he became a priest. And the villages that he went to serve were living with the aftermath of Napoleon Bonaparte's wars. Economies had been devastated, villages had been devastated, families, health, jobs, everything was torn asunder and people were desperate. And so he wrote a poem. And then 2 years later, he invited a friend to write the song, the music to go with it. And one night on Christmas Eve in 1818, right after the service, his friend brought out the guitar, and Joseph Moore and Franz Gruber sang the first ever rendition of Silent Night. It has become the most beloved carol sung anywhere around the world. It was quickly picked up. People didn't even know who had written it. It went to the Salzburg Fair, and it flew around the world. And then guess where it showed up? Does anybody remember the stories of the armistice? Last year was again the anniversary of Armistice Day, right? And in 1918, on the battlefield, on Christmas Eve, some young Englishmen started to hear familiar words. Well, familiar tune, but not familiar words. The Germans were singing Silent Night. And then the Englishmen joined in, and they went into the place between the no man's land, between the trenches. And they put down their guns. And for a very brief period of time, they believed in the peace that they were singing about. They played soccer. They shared food and stories. And then they went back to war and they picked up their guns again. But for a very brief time, there was peace in the middle of the worst conflict imaginable. And a song brought it to them. Songs don't belong just in the scriptures. They belong in our lives too. We've been talking about the power of songs for the last 5 weeks, but tonight I share with you the story of Jean Limmer. Jean Limmer is the dance teacher here in the Valley. And 7 weeks ago, she started working in the adult day center for people that are living with dementia and Alzheimer's. And when she dances with them, she doesn't use words at all. She asks them, they're all seated, they're in a big circle with her, and she asks them, what does your body feel like today? What does your body want to do when it's dancing and singing? And she says she's had the most extraordinary response to that question from these adults, because they've lived such long lives that they can tell with their body amazing stories. And so one of them's like, and they're sitting, unlike me, who's moving my balance. And sometimes they're doing, one man stands up and he twirls around and he tells everybody that he is a dancer. She helps people bring themselves back to a place of connection with body, mind, and spirit. And she does it without words, but she does it with music and dance and song. But we know that song by itself lights up all the parts of the brain. When I go visit people in the nursing home, if they can't remember their children's names and we begin to sing Joy to the World, They know all the words. Music brings us back to ourselves, and it offers us all the gifts of Advent: hope, peace, joy, and love. Tonight, you are invited to reflect on the songs of the season and to take them into yourself and carry them out again when you leave here. To invite yourselves, your hearts, your love to become the home for light and love in this world. And speaking of song, let us have Dominique share.
Great things for me. God has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. God has filled the hungry with good things.
Lord, to sing with us. We implore our sinners. So Wendy and Lori, if you come forward, please. Now light the candle of peace. Ready, East? The prophet Isaiah.
Thank you.
And now we're going to light the candle of joy. Ready, geese? In response to the wonder of the sight, a song of joy as I go down to the shepherds. The gospel tells us there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. An angel of the Lord stood before them, and they were terrified.
Thank you.
whole life is measured by God's law.
Tonight, right now, we're going to ask.
ask that you will help us help others. In the last 24 hours, this church has been asked to help with emergency funding for people's housing, to cover groceries, to provide assistance with winter tires, as well as to work internationally. publicly in the last year. So this is a big deal that people are sharing their gifts of music with us this evening. Please join me in prayer. Oh, Holy God, we ask that you will bless this outpouring of gifts that has been offered this evening, that the song of love may work its way into the places where it is most needed, beginning here in our hearts and our bodies and our lives and our minds. And it may stir us and inspire us, and we may leave here tonight with the gifts of this song, blessing us, that we may go out as blessings. Thanks be to God. Please rise for the joy to the world.
Thank you.
Love was born into the darkness, and love and light overcame the darkness. Lift up your light. Open yourselves to this light. And go from here, knowing that you are children of light. This is the gift of love in your lives, and this is the gift that you pass along to others. When you leave here tonight, we offer you a pocket full of origami stars. Keep a piece of light for yourself, and continue to share it with others beyond these walls. Go in peace.